Hello and welcome to Dell's Gaming. You join me here in the From the Depths Designer. And we're going to be doing a little new build or some thinking about a build. So after the last little battle, it got me thinking about some potential new ships and what was good and bad and some changes that were maybe required. So we're going to start by looking at a new ship. Okay, things I like. Something that caught my eye on the last one was, I think it was either the Turtle Cruiser or a Turtle Destroyer, maybe possibly Turtle Destroyers, their little AA guns on the front. They were quite effective actually against some of the lower flying large targets. So I quite like those, and I want to possibly look at a new cruiser level vessel that we can. It's got some of those guns along with the missiles, and just create a slightly heavier AA cruiser. We'll call it a heavy AA cruiser. So it's going to be slightly larger than our existing cruiser. The other design side I want to go is, I want to go a little bit more with this whole turtle part of the design, and we'll make it a bit wider. So it's going to be, we're going to go, and I might put this through to the other versions of the ship as well, going to a slightly wider design. There's advantages of the wider design and some disadvantages. Right, one pro of the wider design is it will be more stable in the water, less likely to rock, without going to the pontoon style design I see where a lot of people don't like that myself. They still turn over. If they ever turn over, they're still done for. Still going to go for a standard hull keel design, but it will be wider in the beam. Not square, still rectangular, so slightly elongated. Bad downsides, it will be a little slower, I think, because there's going to be more drag. We'll still be using the hydrofoils though to get it out of the water initially. Other downside is it's a bigger target from the top. So from the top, they'll see more to hit. So we'll need good shields, but it will be a turtle with an arm at the top. Turtle thing is about having that shell, and we're going to work out a good shell to cover the top of it. Other pros of this is the inside will have under the hull, the top, will have more room to expand out our cannon systems. So they could still rotate. We can expand out their turning area that we can use and still have them turning. So we can make a bigger gun or more modules on the gun for the same depth of height. Talking about that, thickness might not be so as high, but we're gonna have to go around that 6-7 block type of area. So I will change this and possibly pull that into some of the other ships as well. Go back and redo all our other ones to be a version 2 turtle, so they're more turtle-like. So this will be a total turtle technological turnaround. And I want to say that again. So so we're going to start though with a slightly different design. Now I'm going to put some annotations in the or time codes in the comments, so if you want to skip some of these sections and just see the end result, hopefully there will be a time code down in the comments section. But for the moment, let's get building. So let's start with a new vehicle design. Get that block out there on its own just as a starting point. There we go. Okay, now we're going to obviously start with a nice metal base and do the usual, I think that would be a starting point. Now a bit more, this is going to be a large ship, we need to put that mirror line on. Is that on? Yeah, I think that's on. So we're going to go through the basics in the normal way that I go through all of these systems. But we don't allow for this being a slightly wider ship initially, as we just discussed. And I'm just trying to work out what's large and what's too large. Okay, we'll go with, I think, one more. We're going to have some thick sides. And this base can always go upwards. So actually, I think that might be one too many. We'll see how we go with this here. Okay, so we're going to need a bit of room at the front, obviously for armor and sloping up. But the first bits here could slope that way, then back again to give us that slope. Yeah, I think that width's going to be about right. I think if we look above, yeah, that'll be fine. That'll be fine. So let's go for this AA gun design first. Now, one thing I'm interested in doing is, instead of just copying that one gun, if you've got one barrel shooting at something, that's great. But what about four barrels? So I'm going to try for a four-barreled sort of autocannon type gun. Now, we're going to need a fair bit of room for this, because it's going to need to, there's going to need a fair bit of work underneath on this item. So let's start with a precision turret, because that's obviously going to be the starting point. And we're going to start it just here, and we'll see how we go from there. So, basics of it. Let's get a metal block going up as our first point. Now, what we're going to need here, let's see, how high is the hull going to be? Let's say we go with this four block up, so everything is going to have to fit with this four. So that's the point of the hull. Now we'll go up one more. That's the hull point, and that's starting to be above. Where this comes in, it will be in a second, will become relevant, and how we're going to design this. We're going to just secure this. I'm using beams. There we go. There. And there. Now, one thing when you're making a multi-barreled design is your parts can't touch. So you've got to have at least a one gap between all of your parts. But the guns have still got to connect. So let's just work out the connection for the barrel. So if we start with firing pieces now, and we're going to put them at the back as well, but the back ones are going to have to come up one so they don't hit each other. So let's see, firing piece, let's go back here, put the firing piece in first. Let's put the firing pieces in the firsts. Right, so there we go. Now obviously I could put a, I will put a mirror line on this in a minute. So that will be our firing pieces. So staggered four firing pieces. Now I need to connect them up to the six ways. So let's, we will start putting the mirror line in now. There we go. We'll go forward and backwards. Is that in that right? That doesn't look like the right place. That looks better. So there, yep. And onto the side. Does that give us a connected? Okay, we'll see if we're seeing there, not connected to firing piece, connector there, brings up the queue menu. So that's now connected. So we have that is actually connected as far as that goes. Now, so that means going down, this firing piece has got to fit into this, basically the quarters of the square without touching. If these six-way connectors start connecting here, it goes all strange, and basically everything will, on one side will just basically, it goes bad, it goes wrong. Let's just leave it like that. So we don't want that happening. Now, okay, down here we have our connector for gun A. Take it down to that position, and down here we're gonna have the rear guns. And we'll take them to there, just so that we know. Now we're going to try and make these even. So as you can see, there is a slight now. It's not going to be totally possible because that is the hull area. So actually, we're going to make them even underneath, but the rears will have that extra connector on the back. Okay. So as you can see, the design is a little different. Now we're going to have to be designed slightly alternatively. So let's see what we can do. First of all, we're going to need ammo loaders. Let's see. Now, if we put them here, we've either got to stagger them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them here and have them slightly staggered. So this one goes here, and that one goes there, that one there, that one there. And then that's our thing. So we've got four on each of them. That should be fine. Now, I don't know if I go here as well, whether that will benefit. We'll test that in a second. Okay. Now let's put our ammo boxes on. Come on, back level. Ammo box. Right, okay. 2, 3, 4. So there's nothing touching yet. Good, good, good. Here we go. Right, okay, let's just have a look at that. So that would have a reload time 1.27. Now, without putting an ammo box on, because we want to make these fast firing, if I put another one in there, 1.27, yes, that made a difference without actually requiring any ammo boxes. So I like that. That'll speed it up. Excellent. Right. That'll make it, and we can put an ammo box on the end of that. 1, 2, so that's an ammo box on the end. Excellent. Now we can fill in the gaps in between, we can't go that high, with various little bits and pieces, just to, like armor piercing and more ammo boxes, etc. And then we can sort out the top. So let's get this bottom part done sorted. These aren't going to be minimum gauges. We will try it first without a gauge. I've got room to put a gauge on each of the guns if need be. We're going to try it with minimum high rate of fire, high armor piercing. A little bit of explosive, but mainly armor piercing. So we'll just start with... Now, as you can see, we've got room under here for expansion. Now, the only problem here is if we put things on these corners, it gets confusing as to which gun it's connected to. So I'm going to try and stick away from them. What we will do is fill out these areas. So where I can, I'm going to push out that far. That's fine. And the same at the back here. Put an extra one there. And is there any value in putting one in front? And get 1, 2, 3 items. If I put one here and get 1, 2, 3, still free, no benefit. Let's see, how far are we sticking out? We're sticking out 3 that way, so I can go 3 this way, and I could go 1, 2. I could go and fill out these areas here. I need to work out 3 from the center, how far we're sticking out when it comes to rotation. We want to make sure we can still rotate this turret, otherwise that would be a problem. What we'll do is we'll get our guy over here and just make sure that it will rotate. Obviously, we didn't sink, but hey-ho, we get our testing before that bit gets done. It's quite tall, as you can see, this gun. So that's going to make it quite large, but hey-ho, that's the way of it. Okay, I'm just working out the most efficient use of the space. Obviously, we've lost this use here. There may be a way of using that with ammo barrels here to make the there. What you can do is, this is connected to piece 9315. So if we get an ammo box and make sure that we are pointing in the right direction. So 9315. Yep, that's still connected to 9135, and then down here we do the same, but facing the opposite way. Oops, that's not one that way. So that's 3102. No, see, that one's ended up connecting that way. So that's the problem. I don't like that. That's going to just confuse it. So, yeah, that's not going to work. We'll stay away from these center sections, I think. It's just gonna be bad for us. So what we'll do is we'll put some metal blocks in there just to, as a bit of weight and a reminder to not get confused. Right, that's not there, because that's our side. We'll put one in there, protection against any blast damage coming from the top. So that's our centre hull section. Right, where did I get to? Oh yes, we can't use anything there. Right, we can put something in there and there. That's the numbers 1, 2. If I put another one of these in, that gives us 1, 2, 3 blocks. Yep, like that. Back here, if I put one the same at the back, that gives us 1, 2, 3 blocks. Okay, so let's put some explosive down here at the bottom. Explosives on the bottom. 3 there, 3 explosives on each. 1, 2, 3. Now we'll put some armor piercing. 1, 2, 3. And that's okay to go here. No, that's our thing, so it's here. 1, 2, 3. So what's that given us as far as potential goes? APF 5.7. Now I think explosive, I think we'll give that a little bit more AP. Let's give that a little bit more AP. Let's swap around that explosive for that and that one for that, and we'll do the same over here. So explosive is going to be rare. We're going for armor piercing most of the time. 7.1. Okay, let's go with 7.1. Is that the same on all of them? 7.1? Yep. Okay, we'll go with that. That's going to be a good starting position. Right, what else are we gonna need? We'll put one predictor in here. If I put it in here, it doesn't matter which one it connects to, as long as it goes to one of them, that'll be fine. Right, barrels. I need a elevation barrel, and we want to make sure we keep the elevation at 80. We want to get some accuracy. We want some accuracy, obviously. but it's not the key. We're going for massed fire in the general direction of the enemy. So we'll go for 3 motorized barrels, and then we'll go for 3 normal barrels. See what that gives us. Like that. How much is that? That's 80. If I put another one on each, is that should pull us down again. Yes. So we have to do even numbers. What's the accuracy on that? 3.36. That might be a little too low, actually. Whoops. Come on. It's not removing properly. Or it doesn't look like. Okay, let's go for... we'll go for 5 on each. So that's 5 of those, and then 5 normal barrels. Something like that. Accuracy 1.74. Okay, we'll go with that. We'll see how that works and how that looks. On the scale of things, that's already taken up quite a lot of room, and I might put a second one of those on the rear and not have a main gun. We'll see how that pans out. Okay, we now need to think about the turret, armoring it and making it so that it's got some slope, etc. Now gauges, should I put a gauge on this? Let's just see what that does for our system. So because I could just put it there and on here on the rear so it doesn't connect. So that just gives us a 1 gauge. What does that give to us? Accuracy is up, reload time 0.59. let's just have a check on that. So slightly better reload times if I don't. Yeah, actually I might go without. We'll see how that does without it. The kinetic damage is higher. It's not making a change to AP. Let's just check. Kinetic damage is a lot higher. AP 7.1. Accuracy is a bit better. Not worried about accuracy. What I'm after is maximum sort of, yeah, I think we're gonna just go with maximum bullets in the air at the same time. So let's not worry about the gauges. It'll make the top of this gun a little smaller as well. Right, so how are we gonna armor this? Is there anything else we need to add? I've added the predictor, except for more armor piercing. Let's see if we can add some more armor piercing to these guns. So I reckon that we can go forward a bit. These two there. And we'll do the same on the back. Excellent. So they're going to have equal. Now what we could do actually is do a split, thinking about this. Right, we've got to that point. Now we could do a little change. Like this one could have an there, and this one could have some more explosive. Except by putting explosives here, we're making it vulnerable. Yeah, don't like that. Don't like that. We're gonna keep it. We're gonna keep them even. Gonna keep them even. Let's not change something which is working fine. That's when we start to muck it up, basically. Right, we're gonna put some metal in here because obviously we want it covered. We're gonna put some metal beams on the side, facing forwards from the center point. There we go. And then that will be our front point. And then from there, we'll come backwards. Whoops. There we go. Backwards to there, and one more backwards to there. Excellent. Put some more metal blocks in just to up this side, just to square that off. Fit it in at the back, and some metal blocks coming forwards and in there just as our cover. Yeah, one step forward in the center than the rest of it. So that and that. Okay, let's get some angled blocks. Obviously this is going to have a bit of vulnerability in the center, quite simply, because there's limits. We can't put any armor, so just there is a big vulnerability to it. The back will just be covered in wood blocks. We're not expecting people to be shooting us from behind. It may happen, in which case shit happens. There we go. So that's our basic AA gun. Now we could put a small shield on this. I'm just thinking that, just to give it that little extra protection. Shield projector. Oops, where are we? Obviously we've got no power in this at the moment. So this is working well though. I like this. Right, we'll put it one side in. Let's take out that block there and put it in there. Okay, we'll work it out quickly. Cute. There we go. Put it on reflect. Obviously I can't see anything at the moment because there's no power. So until we've got some power, I won't be able to set that up. So we'll set that on none for the moment and go and set that up later. Okay, so that's done. We will have to, once we've got the hull in place, we'll make sure that this still turns around. Now, the one thing I'm going to do is now is save this as a sub-object. So if we go in here, we can save as a sub-object. If I just go here and give it a name of AA turret. There we go. Now what we can do is put a second one. So if we allow, we're going to put one on the rear. or fairly much near the rear. So if we allow a bit for engines, so that's 1, 2, 3. So if we put another, and then we're in the center section, we're going to have missiles and other defenses. So if we put another one, I'm reckoning facing backwards. So this is our rear facing. We can extend the back a bit if we need some more for the engine. Yeah, so if we put this one, let's make sure we get in the center. Da-da-da. About there? I think about there. Whoops, I need to go onto the hull. That's where I am. I'm on the wrong to edit hull, press that. There we go. Right. Da-da-da. I think that's where we said. I might have to extend the back out to put more engine, or I might put a twin engine system in here. Because we got the width, although it's less efficient, we could put two smaller engines in rather than one big one. We'll look at that. Okay. So that's our two nice AA guns. Plenty of DACA coming out of those. Ah, yes. Right, next, missile systems. So let's think about two missile systems. Now, I'm thinking we need an AA missile system, and for short range AA, although these are actually going to be our short range AA. I'm reckoning these will only fire to about 500. That is their primary, but we're going to see if I maybe putting gauges on them might be an idea, just to get their range up, in which case what I can do is put a gauge on the top of each of those, just to see what range they will fire at. Part two then is going to be next missile system. We still haven't worked out what is our missile system, or our system for attacking surface vessels. So surface vessels can either be, well, these will attack surface vessels that get within range as well. These are not going to be just aerial. That is, their design has been for aerial, but they'll quite happily attack anything on the surface as well. But we need a longer range missile system. So yes, we'd have, what we will have is a missile system in the center, which is a range based one for general 1,000 meter surface vessels, and then one down each side, which is a shorter, say about 600 meter aerial target system. And the aim of this vessel will be to hunt down aerial targets and get within about 500 meters. So we'll set that as their primary. That's what's going to be for these, and that will be the primary AI. We'll have a secondary AI, which is just for these missiles. So, okay, let's think this through. Hell's going to come down to about here. So, okay, we've got some room about this position for a couple of missile launch systems. Now we'll put them about here, facing upwards, and then put a mirror line in the center of the vessel. I said in the center of the vessel, thank you. Right, so this is just going to be behind this area. Yeah, about there. Eight missiles, so that's going to give us 16 in total. And these are going to be primarily fast speed against air targets. Let's see, where's the hull? The hull's going to be about that level. So that's the hull. So I'll go up onto another level with these. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. We'll make these fives. Then, so these will be five range missiles. I'm not going to worry about things like ejectors, because we're new design, we're not going under the water so far. Now I'll put the AIs, I think, somewhere around here. We need to some six-way connectors. And we'll then put all of our controllers on that, on these blocks. So just to free up some space, one controller there, that will fill them up. So just to give a notice of what we're gonna do here, we'll have a short range thruster, two fins, four fuel tanks, a one turn, a target precision, proximity, infrared. All right, we're gonna end up with one warhead on that. So either reduce the range, take out the target precision. I like the target precision. So I'm gonna take out a little bit of range, put the one turn here, target precision, proximity, and then we'll have a frag and a explosive based upon my previous testing. We're gonna go for, we might go for a damage potential rather than anything else. So we might reverse that around. The proximity, yeah, we'll go for explosive here to hit anything that gets in range. And if it gets a, okay, we'll go with this. Explosive will get anything within a short range, and the fragment, we're gonna have the fragment at quite a range in case it gets a weird angle, so it's not to be an armor piercing shot, this one. This is going to be a bit more area effect, still forward facing this, but a bit more of a hitting the, you know, anything vulnerable in the area. The explosive will get anything to the side, so yeah, okay, that's fine. This should have a range, I'm guessing around 700 or so. So we'll put the same on this side. Now we could actually make this one slightly different. I didn't set the also something I have put a bug up with is that if you change the warhead arming delay on your ships, which is a new thing that people are doing, it doesn't get saved. That's a bit of a problem, so hopefully they will sort that one out for us at some point. Okay, so there we need a bit of a delay. So I always like having a little delay, so I quite like it when it pops out of the water and then sort of does something. Right, we'll still have two fins, we'll still have three, so it's about the same ranges. Now this is where we will change it a little bit. We'll need a one turn. Now where do we make the changes? Now that one had target position. Now the only problem is augmented, I found, does not work very well with one turns at all. I haven't found a good way of using these on vertical launch missiles. It's fine on missiles which are fired in a particular direction, but vertical launches, I've not found it work very well at all. Okay, so let's just see on this one. Now we could either not use target precision, so one's got target precision and one's not, so that way if one hits, or if one's getting pulled away by target precision, hopefully the other will not. And we can make this, maybe we'll still put the proximity in, which is going to be a standard 45 degrees 5 meter, but we could go for a few more frags on this. Or let's see, we could put a camera. Now I haven't experimented with the cameras yet, and cameras are quite good. What they do is they allow you to change what the AI seeker aims for. Now there's lots of numbers here, but generally you just got to look at the bit that says center of mass. As far as I'm aware, all of these numbers have exactly the same effect. Aim at shield generators, aim at random blocks, aim at hot things, which is the standard. So you can change it on here of what to go for. By default it goes for, I believe, center of mass. So this one I could say go for aim at hot things as an example, and then put our damage in, and then put our two systems in there. So we'll go with that, just see how these go. Explosive warhead there, and our fragmentation just here. Now we're actually going to change a little bit here because I'm going to put the camera there because it doesn't matter. So it duplicates the other side proximity. Then we'll put our fragmentation and then explosive. So it's similar to the other side. Right, explosive or fragment. Again, we're going to have 30 degree. And the infrared we'll set at hot things. Okay, so a couple of slightly different missiles, but many similarities, but not too much. Right, we'll need friend or foes on both of these. Come on. There we go. Okay, we'll put the friend and foe that end, and we'll put the stagger down this end as well. Stagger, yeah, we'll give it. I like a long delay. I don't like them firing too fast. I like a nice stream. It also, I think, helps against lambs, because lambs will do a little bit at a time. So you can see the slightly different design there with the camera. That's what the camera looks like. Okay, now we will need, on the AA side, a local weapons controller on both of these, facing in the right way. There we go. And we will need a... I'm going to put a failsafe in these. I'll show you why. I've got a new idea, a new plan. I want to return to something I'd done previously on these ones with the new failsafes. The failsafes are a little bit better now, and we'll see how they work. We'll generally set these up to be a maximum range. We're going to start with a maximum range of about 700, I think, will be a good starting point. They might go a little bit longer than that, and they'll attack anything, but a minimum altitude. They won't attack things under the water, so a minimum altitude of 2. Okay, set that up on the same. That doesn't get modified with the words are gone. Doesn't get saved with the mirror or changed over. So okay, that's those two. They're both ready to set up for the main target. Okay, that's them done. Now we're gonna put some covers on them. That's why I haven't done this. So as soon as something's in 700, there's gonna be a covers will come across or come back, and they'll start firing, hopefully. It may work, it might work not. I'm gonna give it a go. So now we've got left with, we haven't got attacking surface vessels. We've got a lot of space available still. Okay, got a couple of options here. One, nice big turret in the center. That'd be good. Or I might go for a laser guided missile system with some injectors. The idea being they're going to toss these up into the air quite high, laser locks on, and then they come down. So the we have a high shoot up with 4 thrusters on each. Now this is going to make the design a little bit more awkward than normal to fit them in. So if we start with our missile block, they're going to have to be a 5 or 6 missile. So we're going to have a bit of a hump in the centre, but this is a turtle, so it doesn't really matter if it's got a bit of a hump. Now I want to make sure that there is at least a bit of a block here difference, so that we'll be able to put some protection going up. Now we've got to plan this out a little bit. Now I can either go for a symmetrical design, or it's going to have to be, now the reason for this is because of the ejectors. So if I just show you what I mean, if I put a launch pad up here and then put ejectors all around it, where are we? Where's my ejectors? There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we basically need 1 between each. So we won't get many missiles here. So that's fine. I think we might go for some, just a few but very damaging. Yeah, let's go for some big hitters. Why not? Let's go for some cruise missiles, because we haven't really done that on our, even on our big missile destroyers, aren't really cruise missiles as such. So let's go for 8 big cruise missiles, laser guided. That's not going to be right. That needs to go connected there, which means this needs to go back one more. So this is going to be our heavy missile cruiser. Mainly AA based, but it's going to be a heavy missile cruiser. That sounds interesting. Okay, let's put these in, and then get our ejectors in. So yeah, we'll see how this works. We're going to we're going to put a delay on the missiles, so they'll pop up to as high as possible out in the water, allowing for the new design. These ships are going to only just be in the water, not be too far up. Now we're going to allow a bit of a height a slide just there. So then we're going to put in our missile blocks. Now how big a missile shall we have? Now looking at this here, that's 6 blocks. That might be as many as we can go without making this serious, it start interfering with this turret. So I think 6 blocks is the limit. The option is I could go 7 blocks and take off one ejector. Nah. We'll go with that. We'll go with that. 7 blocks. 6 blocks, sorry. We'll see what we can do with 6. So this will be our missile cruiser, for want of a better word. We'll go with that definition, I think. So I've changed it from AA, but its main job is going to be AA. We'll fill this whole area in with a lot of metal near the top, but otherwise it's going to be there. We'll just put the basics in here so we can see. So missile controller. Thank you. We'll put the I don't think I need an identify friend and foe here, because that's only for AI infrared. So we'll just put that one in there, but we'll give this a nice 0.5 second delay. Now we'll need the controller. So this is going to be aiming for our ground targets. We might even give this its own AI, actually. We'll see. Now I would say about making the AI a little bit stronger than it is. So let's just try something here. If I do, I want to see how, if we can put an AI mainframe just here, a weapons controller on top of it, or connected to the side of it. Yeah, okay. And then this will have its own, it needs a main, whoops, wrong one, an AI front and back card, because all it needs will be, I think this will work, front and back is going to be a target prioritization card. Will that take effect? Not connected. Okay, that didn't work as I expected. What I want, let's try that again. Front and back card. So if I aim it that way, I thought that should connect at the front here, not on the sides. And that allows me to put a card here? No. Yeah, that should be. Oh, I don't want to do that. I want to put the card here, not there. Okay, if I face it that way. Okay, it's not letting me to do what I want to do. That's annoying. It's automatically turning it. So that's there, which means that then I have to put that on the sides here. Oh well, if it's got to go there, it's got to go there. Target prioritization. There we go. At least it's, oops, take the mirror line off. Take one of them off. So not as ideal as I'd like. But now at least this AI is totally independent of the rest of the ship. So we can set its own prioritization and its own ranges. Right, the missile. Right. Short range thruster. With, we'll work it out, but a nice long delay. It's going to be laser guided, which means we actually have to put in our laser designator. Oops. And we're going to need to make sure it's got multiples. So we'll go up with here for this first bit, about that high. Missiles, laser emitter. In fact, I'm going to change that, because what we're going to do is come up about, that will be in missiles, so about here. There is a reason for this madness. I'm just going to go a little higher. There we go. We'll cover that. Edit. Missile laser emitter. Now the reason for this is we will come out somewhere about here. Somewhere around there we will put in the ability to have another laser emitter. So that's so that if the they're slightly to the side or a turret's in the way, etc., it will still shoot. Right, where did I get to on these missiles? Here we go. I was working on this one. Let's just go through this. So laser designator, short range thruster. Now I want maximum good penetration. This is going to be good penetrating missile. Let's just put this one fin. It's not going to be that turn. Four fuel tanks. Don't need a one turn because we're laser designated. So now if I put a proximity fuse here, I've now so that we can get this standoff guaranteed hit, we can put in a fair number of mixed explosives. So I'm going to go for two explosives on the front and two fragmentation. Now, one fragmentation, based on what I'd previously done, I'm going to have one that this fragmentation, no, I'm going to make these penetrators. So 1 degree, and then the one behind it is going to be, say, a 3 degree. So this is going to, explosives basically take out any surface area in quite a large area, and these will then penetrate through. If the if we've already got a hole, the explosives will just start hitting away at the surface area, and the fragments just damaging anything that's inside. Yes, I like this. Range, not going to be great. We'll have to work on that four there, but okay. Let's just assign that to all. But that's generally a good start. Okay, I'm just going to lay out a few bits and pieces else. Right, what I haven't allowed for is, where the hell am I going to sit? I don't know yet. Where am I going to sit? Where's my thing? I've got to allow a bit. I've only got a little. I could sit just behind this and have a short area. I don't have to have a lot. If I allow, let's put some blocks in here. Metal blocks, just as a. I haven't got my mirror line on. Thank you. Right, there we go. And we're going to have some metal blocks down here. That's going to be blocked off. And let's see, that's the limitation of that. So that might have to go to there to still be able to turn. I've got to test the turning ability of these yet. And the same here, we might need to bring, so yeah, no room for AI in this area here. One block is not be enough, assuming I need that amount of space. Let's go front here, one, two, one block in front of it, same at the front. Basically, I'm mostly allowing more than I need here, but I'm just trying to make sure that I don't block the turret. So this is just laying out the limits for those. That's all going to be solid out, going out the side, and possibly curving around a little bit with about three blocks armor, especially on the top, maybe wood on the bottom. Okay, or slightly hollow on the bottom. Where have I got some room? So no room here either. We'll make that a double thickness potentially. Anywhere else I've got room? Okay, my AI, I'm looking like I'm in with the engine. I'm in with the engines. Or I could be in with the missiles. I could see the missiles launching either side of me. That's at the same time as being interesting, that's rather dangerous. But as I say, interesting. Okay, what if I was to do this? Which way is forward? That way is forward. And then let's get some metal beams. Oz has a plan. Let's do that slightly differently. Let's use beams when we can, because they are better protection, quite simply. Come on, stop doing that. There. I want you just there. Thank you. Ugh. Computers. Right, we're going to have, let's say there's, let's see, where else are we going to need? We're going to second level. One, two. Now we can start going to the side here. And then, so we're going to be right in the center of this. We will see the missiles launching either side of us. There we go. So we've got beam, basically, defenses there. And that will give us enough room to put our seat and AI. Now, I might want a little bit, that's a little bit of a thing. Is that enough room? That's going to be enough room. So we'll put our seat in here. There we go, and we'll be able to see what's firing and as the missiles shoot up and etc. So that'll be quite interesting actually. We'll put the controller a bit further forward just there, and then as is my normal, we'll put the AI. There's my AI mainframe. This is going to be the primary AI there with its transmitter on the top. Front and rear card, left and right slot, take off the here, and we will put a naval card and a target prioritization card. And the only other bit I've just realized I haven't done on here, in fact, since we've got prioritization, I can put an aim point selector on here, which would be good for the laser. Yes. Yes. I like that. That's good. Okay. And then we're going to have lots of control blocks in here. It's going to be lots of control blocks doing lots of things. There we go. Okay. That's taken us quite a while. So what I'm now going to do is fill in the hull and time-lapse it. And when we come back, we should have hopefully the basis and the basics of this ship and ready to work, he says. And I'll have to put the engines in on the back, of course, and shields. And we'll be ready for some testing if I'm with any luck. So See you in a short while.
nicht diese Töne, sondern lasst uns angenehmere anstimmen und freudenvollere. Betreten feuertrunke himmlischen ein Heiligtum. Deine Zauber binden wieder, was die Mode streng geteilt. Alle Menschen werden Brüder, wo dein sanfter Flügel war.
Yes.
Hello and welcome back. It's been quite a long build process on this particular craft. There's quite a few balancing issues I had to go through. I'm sure I've cut a lot of what I did out, but I showed you the most of the build. Okay, what have we got? So we've got four turrets. We have covers for our missiles, which hopefully you saw in operation, which will only open up if there is enemy in range. We've got good shields. We've got a lot of wood on the side acting as basically armor, ablative armor effectively, and then we've got a metal armor, very heavy at the front, and getting larger. Certain areas are double thinned, but it's not amazingly heavy, but there's also good shields. Also aimed, it's got a reasonable speed out of battle, 15. Not as good as some of the others, but 15 is not bad for it. Considering its size, it is big. This is more larger than the previous cruiser we created. But hey, you know, that's going to be part of it. It's a 3,000 blocks, half a million RP points, 162,000 metal. So I won't be bringing it in straight away. It might need a bit of a workup. Okay, let's give it a little bit of a battle test, shall we? So let's see. Now I've aimed this to be good against especially aircraft. So let's try a few planes against it. Let's put some shrikes and a gotha and a few drakes in there. That's a hell of a lot of, actually. Let's see how it does. I'll see if these guns work on it. So what we should have seen, as you can see, it's gone under the water, but the guns are still above the water, which means they will be more accurate. Which is good. Oops, I just come off of the up there. We have the covers come back across the radar missiles and the other ones to make them fireable. See how we're doing. That was quite a lot of troops to bring in one go, I must admit. I must have overdid that. Oh well, never mind, eh? If it survives, it shows it's worth it. So we've got missiles still being fired up, batches of 8 missiles. The missiles were split, some were high explosive and some are fragmentation. So some have got predictors and some don't have predictors. So I've tried to do a bit of a mix and match type of situation with the air. And our air-to-air guns, are they going? I'm not sure which one they're going for. I haven't sorted out the target prioritization yet for them. This is the first air-to-air test I've done with these so far. So they're possibly just going for the largest. As you see, most of my aerial missiles have proximities on them. It's trying to catch up with that shrike, which is being a bit of a pain. And the AA guns, yeah, they're doing alright. I've taken some damage. I'm not going to get out without any damage whatsoever. I'm just hoping that the damage won't be too great. Ammo production is a little low. It looks like we've taken some severe damage in one engine. We have a dual engine setup, so hopefully if one engine takes damage, the other will be all right. Yeah, we can see they've gone through to one engine. Hopefully we'll repair that shortly. One gun's taken a bit of damage, but the AA guns are peppering that Gotha. You can see it's peppered this to buggery. I think I overdid the amount of targets we had here, but hey, let's go for this. What if there was two of them? We'll add in a. I think in general it's holding its own. It is defeating things. I say. It was, if we can get through this, as I say, it was that was mostly a few too many troops. Okay, that's the back of the Beaufort, and it is going for now the Shrike. You see the lasers are pointing at the Shrike. It's got its engine back up and running, so 5,000. That was handy because we kept one engine. The dual engines worked quite well on that. One engine kept working, although obviously it couldn't supply all of the requirements, but it did keep on working. Our guns have been quite good. Let's see how these guns go against this Drake. Oop, have they changed target? They have. It's Duster. Or is it the Shrike? Oh, that's another gun. Yeah, these guns are working quite well. I think that they're doing a reasonable job. Against fast-moving targets, they're possibly not great. And I might turn them off so that against fast-moving targets, they don't fire. Let's see how they do against this here. That's the sheer... The inaccuracy sort of version actually makes them basically pepper the whole area with missiles. So okay, that's not too bad, but I might just change them a little bit just to limit there, so not the fastest. Let's go and have a check how fast some of these targets are. See this way. So if I go into here, you see some of the target maximum speed. Some of these speeds are very high, so if we say these should go for the slower targets of up to 20. And then down here as well, tell him to go for a maximum of 20. Actually, we'll set this one a little bit different, so set one, this one to be 25. Yeah, we'll set this one to be 20 and the one at the rear to be slower targets. So they might define to in that way, attack different targets. Set this to be slow. Come on, get to the new channel. We need the details. Can't get it, come on, bloody thing. Excuse my language, sometimes it frustrates me. Right, we'll make this one, say, 50, or maximum of 10. Slow moving targets, this one. That might be too slow, this is 50. 15 was fine. The other one's 20, this one's 50. And how's it done? Yes, it has cleared the skies of all those targets. So that is a good working ship. I like that. Now it looks like the rudder needs a little bit of work. So that it turns the ship towards it, but I think it's actually classed that now as all done. You see how it's gone out the water? That's when the target is beyond a certain range that it's aiming for. Oh, no, it's gone back in again. It's obviously found a slow target. Right, let's put a ground target in just to see how it works against a something like a plunderer. So this should fire its laser guided missiles now. Second, wherever it's gone, there it is. So you can see the laser missiles. Now a laser missile should fire up and then fire in a second, I'm hoping. Now they are slightly more powerful. Let's go over here and have a look at the impacts, hopefully. So the laser ones are going to aim primarily at this. Now there's obviously a lot of... it's got lambs, So some of our missiles are not going to get through, which is disappointing, unfortunately. On this, I've forgotten that he had lambs. Should have done a different target. But it'll be good to see how he does against this. Can our target take out these lambs? I do think what I need is decoy missiles. So lots of small numbers of missiles was the other idea. So that the lambs would go after the small ones, and then the big heavy ones would follow up later. But I've gone for this design at the moment. With other ships firing missiles in as well, I'm sure it will eventually do a good little job. You see they're coming down quite nicely at it. I think the others are going to start firing now. Yes, we're starting to get impacts. Even when it is getting lambs on them, this is coming in at enough of a rate that it's going to be doing serious damage. We might need to work on some fins or other bits for the missiles just to make them a little bit more effective. Let's see if he can do it. Come on, boy. Come on. Take out that plunderer. I quite like the way it fires them up. They have a bit of a hop and then they are off. There we go. He's taken a bit of damage, but not too much. That's okay. Check on the gun here. We've obviously taken a fair bit of damage on this gun. It's not stopped firing. We just need to work out if that's because of some range figure I've put in here. Could be that speed. Oh, it's over 1,000 meters away. That'll be why then. Not got enough accuracy. Okay, that's fine. It's slowly repairing. Now these radar missiles could still be firing at the second. I think it's got a range of about 750 set though. That's why it's most probably not firing. Just tell it to fire everything, because we're close enough to do that. No, they had enough range actually to get here as well. So what is the range on that? Ooh, so a lot closer than I expected. That's fine, maybe there's something else on those. Anyway, it looks like it can hold its own to a degree. Certainly on the air targets, it held its own quite nicely. I'll work on the ability for the plunderer. Okay, so that's another build done. As I say, I'll just work on the missiles just a little bit. I did give it a little bit much there, I think, to go for in one go, but we'll see how it works. It is still alive. If there was another ship around available to support it, it would be doing quite nicely. Hope you enjoyed that. Please like and subscribe the video. I got any comments about my builds, a new build, or some ideas, please give me leave a comment about it. Until next time, have fun.